Hi guys, welcome to Selenium Automation at the Rate Practical Hands-On. So as a part of the introduction, we are seeing how basics of Selenium framework, automation framework, we are seeing all the components of integration, and then post that we have looked into the Selenium Automation agenda and the table of contents, which we will be covering as a part of this series. So in this part of agenda, we wanted to have a quick recap of that at the directory level, how we are distributed these concepts, these contents at the directory level. So let's see. So this is how we have segregated the content of the topics into various directory levels. So basically, as a prerequisite, we need to cover up one programming language, which is the primary. And in that, we'll be going to cover up Java introduction basics, Java OOPS concepts, Java exception handling, assertions, collections. So these are the most important things, and Java JDBC, design patterns, and then reflection API is completely optional. And once it was done, we have already discussed this Selenium discussion agenda. So what are the contents that I was going to cover, and how we are going to arrange it a part of directory level, now as we are discussing on this. And then we have covered the Eclipse introduction and how to work with Eclipse, and how to use the shortcuts to get more hands-on and work on at a very speed level, and how to do some plugins, how to incorporate the plugins into Eclipse and all those things, and how to work in Eclipse in a very quick and fast manner using the keyboard shortcuts that have been discussed as a part of Eclipse. And then we have introduced the build management tool in the part of our component discussion. As a part of our component integrations, various components we have looked up like Maven, GitHub, Jenkins, and test and reaction reports, all these things to be covered up as a part of the component integration. And we have started with Maven build automation tool integration, and we have seen the theoretical concepts on Maven and how to work with Maven practically and creating a simple Maven project, and all the basics on Maven have been covered up as a part of this video series. And then we have covered up GitHub practical, theoretical concepts idea, and post that we'll be completing on the practical concepts, how to work on Git and how to work, upload or push it to GitHub, and all those things will be covered in the next series. And post that we'll be looking it into Jenkins integration as a part of the component integration discussion. And then we'll be looking at the unit testing framework test and as a part of the component integration, and then extend to post API as a part of components integration discussion. So these will be covered as a part of components integration discussion. And post that, we'll be seeing how to customize the log using the listeners, and then how to implement the repro methods. And following that, we'll be looking at the test data management using the data driver script using TestNG annotation and Apache Pod. As a part of the Java introduction or the Java programming language concepts, we'll also be covering up file handling. Since it was very important when we are preparing a data driver script for test data driver management, test data management. And then once it was completed, we'll be quickly moving into Selenium. So we'll be introducing the basic structure of Selenium, and then how the framework was designed. And then we'll be looking at how the client server model of Selenium is there. The architecture discussion will be gone. And once it was done, the architecture level discussion was completed, we'll be looking at into the location strategies which are available with Selenium. Prior to that, we'll be looking up with the HTML tags, what are the various tags that will be utilized, what are the basic tags that are available in HTML, and how they will be useful for as a part of Selenium. And then we'll be looking at the location strategies process using various location strategies that are available, and also the JavaScript executor. And after that, once it was done, we'll be having a quick recap of all these components which are integrated, and we'll look at the framework at the high level. And once it was completed, we'll fall back to base object model design pattern. And then we'll introduce this base object model design pattern to the framework. So now our framework will be completed with the base object design pattern. So with this design pattern, we'll have the framework ready. Once it was done, we have the phase of the design pattern framework ready with the data driven tests, and then we have all the components integration integrated. So now the project structure is ready. So the framework part is completed. So once it was ready, we'll fall back to, we'll pick up some project and we'll start working on the project at the practical hands-on. So once it was completed, once the project has been completed, so practically we'll be taking up some Gmail or some other page, some other project, some other sites which are available freely on the net, on the web, and we'll start working on that, how to establish the project from an end-to-end point of view, how to start with the writing test, how to divide it into page objects, how to prepare page objects, and how to write tests for the page objects, and how to execute it using TestNG, or how to execute it, how to run it, how to schedule it using Jenkins, and how the Jenkins will start executing or triggering the Maven form.xml file, and how Maven form.xml file calls on the TestNG, and TestNG calls on the TestNG XML file and executes its calls on that, and how this complete end-to-end flow will be completed, and then how the reports will be generated, and how we can present the reports, and all those things will be covered on this discussion session. And finally, once everything was completed with the project, then we will be falling back to a quick recap. We will be taking a quick recap of the implemented project, how to discuss it, how to explain to someone. For an example, in an interview, if someone asks, how is your project structure? Explain about your project. So we'll be discussing, we'll be taking a quick recap of this practical project which we have implemented and how to discuss it at that point of time. So we'll be looking at all these things. So this is how, this is the basic idea I wanted to give about how we have devised our topics in a structural way. This is how we framed our complete end-to-end automation framework design and other practical hands-on. Thanks guys. Thanks for watching. Thank you all.